1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Welcome to the channel. Today, John Fix has an amazing tool to show you. Enjoy your visit, but remember, beware of the pits.
This is one of the most interesting tools that I have ever owned. Actually, I saw one of these about 20 years ago at a flea market, and a guy wanted $35 cash for it, which I didn't have in my pocket at the time. And of course, it was over that day and he was gone. Never saw him, never had another one, never saw one of these tools again. I found this one in England. I bought it off of eBay, and I talked them into shipping it to me. They didn't have an international shipping program, but I talked them into doing it and paid to have it shipped to me. Nice of the people to do that. And what it is, it's a Raw Plug brand, which was a Raw Plug England company. There was one here in the U.S. that I worked for many years, and that's why I was really interested in it. But it's a Raw Plug mechanical hammer. It's for drilling holes in concrete, block, brick, for setting anchors. This was manufactured in the 1950s. I don't know the exact date, and it was only made in Europe. That's why you don't see them here. It was an earlier model, but I've never found that one. But this model actually is still in working condition. It's going to need to be taken apart and cleaned and serviced. But I don't want to give it much of an operation until I get it apart and really check everything out. But how it works is there's a drill bit that goes in here, which is called a star drill. Got a little star-shaped point. And some of them were three wings and some were four. But how it operated was the tool, when you turn the crank, it hammers on this bit, which hammered into the concrete. Every time it rotated and it kept turning. The hammering was to break up the concrete or the block or the brick, and the turning was to pull the dust out of the hole. Just like modern rotary hammers, which are electric and or battery operated. This was a hand crank tool, so it was the first cordless rotary hammer ever made. Just like there are cordless drills, the old egg beater drills. Well, this is that they took and expanded on that principle and made something that would hammer and turn at the same time. This one actually works. I only gave it a light use because I want to take it apart again and really service it before I do it. And I'll drill a hole in concrete afterward and give a good demo on it. Just an amazing find. This tool is really in good shape. This handle works from both sides. You put it on this side or you can put it on the other side. And I believe you turned it in a reverse motion. I found the original brochure, operator manual for this tool, and that's on the way to me. And I'm going to study that and be sure I have everything right before I do much with it, because it's just an amazing little tool. I don't want to do a lot, but I do want to clean it up. It's got some sort of paint on the handle that's all chipping off, but you know we can fix that. And this is an aluminum housing, seems to be, that's going to need some cleaning up. Got the patent number on it and everything. So, and it says on here on the handle, keep well oiled, turn only when drill is under pressure. When you've got it against a work surface, only turn it. And I did, I put it against a block of wood just for testing, just to make sure. They don't want to free operate it. They want to have it against a work surface. So I'm going to operate it like it should be because I want it working. So we'll be back with a restored tool and a demo. Really looking forward to this one. Well, the exterior's done, the inside, all the parts were clean, checked. Anything bent or misshapen was straightened. Putting it back together was a little tricky, but not too bad. I've got everything ready to put the outer shell on, but the one ingredient that was missing was this 3-in-1 oil. That's an old can of oil. Came from Service Max, $2.19. I don't know when I bought it, but it's lasted a long time. Anyway, everything needs to be oiled, and so it operates properly. Anything that rides on any surfaces or meshes together. And we'll get that done. There's a little mechanism that turns, the gear that turns, and this is the hammer mechanism that hammers on the end of the bed here. But all these mating surfaces needs lube. So we'll be sure and get it everywhere we need it. Don't want to have to take it apart again, I'm sure. Won't have to, that I know of, for any reason, but it was completely bone dry when I got it, if you remember. So we're going to be sure that we've got oil everywhere that's needed. I don't know how much you need, but that seems sufficient. Well, here it is completed. The most amazing, neatest tool that I have ever owned and possibly seen in my life. Really, it's a pleasure to own this tool because of my history and 20-something years of looking for one. Again, raw plug mechanical hammer, British made. All restored, was stripped down, all the parts were cleaned and repaired. The tool properly oiled, and it's a well-engineered tool. I know tools, and looking at it inside, it's a well-made little tool. And one of the nice features is this turning handle. You can see it's got an R and an L for right or left. If you take the handle off and put it on the other side of the tool, this one turns in a forward motion, just like your crank. And when you put it on the other side, you also turn in the forward motion. I think I said earlier that you had to do counterclockwise, but no, you do just the same motion you do over here. So that's a nice feature. It's got an oiler on it here that you open, and you can oil the tool because it just operates just on oil. The tool turns at average rotations of 120 RPM in 480 blows per minute. That's the hammer blows, hammering on the drill bit here to hammer it into the masonry material. It's also advertised as a slow speed drill only. And how you do that is there's an adjustment knob here, and you loosen this all the way and it drills only. And you can tighten it up as tight as you want to regulate how hard the hammer blows are going to be. But you can see if you did at only 120 RPMs, it's going to be a really slow speed drill. I guess it's a feature they put on it. I don't know much what you could do with that. You could get a hole drilled. It would take a while at 120 RPM. Also, the capacity of the tool with these star drills is from 1/8 inch bits up through 3/8 inch diameter bits. It's claimed you can drill 2 inches with a 1/4 inch bit in about 30 seconds. We're going to test drill in some masonry material to show you how it operates. But again, the original cordless drill, no battery, no electricity, small, lightweight. I can see where in its time, back in 1950, that would have been a really handy tool, because the only way to drill that hole prior to that is you had a handheld holder that you put a drill bit in and you hit with a hammer, turning and turning the bit because you're holding it, and then you hit it with a hammer on the end. Would have been a really slow and difficult process. But now let's drill a hole and see if it works as well as advertised. I've got a lightweight concrete block here, and I've got it chucked up in my vise to hold it. Let me get the tool and see what we can do about drilling a hole. Well, it's starting to get a small hole in there. It's taking some work. Okay, the result of all that drilling gave us about a half inch depth of hole. Might be about right. It depends on what you're drilling in. This is not a terribly hard material. It's a cap block, a cinder block, which is fairly lightweight compared to concrete. But it did drill the hole as advertised with a little effort. Really neat little tool. Excited to have it in my collection, because of my history in the drilling and anchoring business, and also because it's just very rare. Had to bring it over from England. You know, it was never marketed here in the United States, and the history that I read shows it being sold in Europe, primarily in Belgium and England, and again, for its time, it was a great tool because there weren't any rotary hammers that did this. They hadn't been invented yet. Only the awkward method of drilling with a star drill I showed you by hand. So this was a vast improvement over that. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching this amazing tool.